Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your presence. And I will start first. When Güler Hanım invited me to speak at Turkish Cultural Foundation's circles of lectures on the exchange of population between Greece and Turkey in 1923, we decided that the topic should focus on the cultural contribution made by exchanged populations to their place of settlement. We therefore decided on a double lecture in which two academics, one from Greece and one from Turkey, would each talk about the contribution made by refugees who arrived and settled in his particular country. So, I will speak to you about the cultural contribution made by Rum Orthodox Christians who were forced to leave Anatolia and settle in Greece according to the Treaty of Lausanne. Prior to this, I will briefly present the historical context surrounding the history of Rum refugees to whom this paper is dedicated. The majority of Rum population fled in terror in 1922 following the defeat of the Greek army, using any kind of boats which they used to reach the Greek islands in the Anatolian coasts. Greece found herself with most of the Rum Anatolian population on her hands and with an accumulated mass of property questions to settle. The refugees in 1922, being entirely destitute, suffered terribly. It was only gradually that they were directed towards the Greek provinces where there were vacant lands, chiefly in Macedonia and Western Thrace. They furthermore suffered terribly for many epidemics. There were two remaining groups, that of Istanbul and that of Anatolia. In central Anatolia and Black Sea, the exodus progressed regularly throughout the year 1924 and the beginning of 1925. 80,000 Rums left Cappadocia and Cilicia, 10,000 from the Ankara region, 50,000 from the Black Sea. The departure started in October 1924 and finished 1926. They could take only their portable goods. Totally, an estimated 1,200,000 refugees arrived in Greece. It is not difficult to appreciate the terrible problem the arrival of these huge number of people presented to the Greek state. This population was 26% of its former population of approximately 5 million local people. The rehabilitation and integration of refugees from Asia Minor, from the Asia Minor catastrophe, was and remains the biggest achievement in peacetime of the modern Greek state. I will discuss in which fields these Rum refugees who arrived in Greece in two waves in 1922 and later during the exchange of population made a distinct contribution how the arrival and settlement affected the people of Greece, what emerged from this fusion. I will not speak about the fields in which this cultural contribution becomes linked with the financial contributions made by this workforce to the revival of the wooden poverty-stricken Greece. They arrived with nothing, bringing only their art, their skills in certain basic sectors of craftsmanship, agriculture, commerce, etc. And it is well known the refugees' contribution to Greece's economic revival during the years after their settlement. I shall speak to you on the contribution made by refugees to aspects of daily life, where ultimately the essence of life lies. My maternal grandmother was from Cappadocia, and she, unforgettably, used to tell me, "Jam, bogazdan gelir, bogazdan tsikaria vou." I will start from gastronomy. Our dear friends, gastronomy is a people's valuable collective cultural creation made up of manners, customs, memories, history, religion, and of course, pleasure. It is known to include people's coded perceptions of life, of their relationship with the world. Excuse me. When the thousands of refugees reached Greece, they brought with them a valuable culinary education, culture. These Orthodox populations from the Aegean coasts, from central Anatolia and Black Sea, had in their homelands alongside and together with the Turkish, Turkmen, Armenian and Kurdish populations developed a cuisine much more advanced than the Hellenic, rich in flavors, imaginative in occasions, in methods, and extensive as to the acceptance and use of a variety of materials. This cuisine, which was not unlike the culinary system prevailing in mainland and insular Greece, brought about, when combined with the body of Hellenic cuisine, its complete revival and expansion affecting its future course. The refugee inhabitants of Anatolia lived for centuries as subjects of the great Ottoman Empire, which, apart from anything else, fused the culinary traditions of the peoples living there. Local cuisines were enriched by elements from neighboring as well as distant areas of the empire. The dishes given names from the dominant language, the dominant culture. So, all this wealth of taste and enjoyment arrived in Greece with the refugees. Dolmadakia gyalantzi, tzatziki, imambaildi, yachni, kapamas, smirneika sutsukakia, and so many other dishes were adopted and took up the place they deserved on the Greek table. Present day Greek cuisine has emerged from the fusion of the local culinary tradition of the inhabitants of old Greece with the Eastern culinary habits brought to the new homeland by the refugees from Anatolia. The synthesis of the two cuisines, Anatolian and Helladic, in the sense of the both combination and mutual influence, was completed with a very short time, as it is well known that only similar cuisines are easily fused. Their fusion included both expanding the range of dishes and enriching the cooking. As when the refugees reached Greece, they not only brought new recipes, but also demonstrated new cooking methods and innovative ideas for preparing new raw materials. Something almost revolutionary happened too. The Greeks began to recognize and gradually to adopt what was behind the Anatolian cuisine: sensuality directed towards enjoyment at the table. This, I believe, was the greatest collateral contribution. It must also be pointed out through that the fusion of the Greek cuisine with that of the Anatolia through the refugees came up against resistance on both sides. The refugees revealed a kind of culinary wariness due to their belief that they had also come to a place of poor culinary education. Throughout my childhood, I heard Turkish-speaking refugees speaking disdainfully among themselves about the locals. I will try to imitate their tone of voice. Άμα σέντε, μου λάρνετε με και με εκπηλεί όλα. Χάιτε, τζάνο. In contrast, the distance at which the Greeks held the refugee cuisine can only be interpreted using criteria of social discrimination. The local community which alienated the refugees, referring to them as Turkosporin, Turkish seeds, also shunning their cooking as it was Turkish. A great scholar and connoisseur, Kostas Zouraris, who for many years signed his articles in a Greek newspaper named Kathimerini, wrote many years before, if the cuisine introduced by the refugees was considered Turkish, that has to do not with gastronomy, but with the social pathology of the Greeks. The inhospitable mood with which the Greeks received the refugees that had been driven from their fatherlands, and the social tremors caused by the arrival of those persecuted people, imposed as a means of self-justification for the locals the ideological rejection of the refugees' culture. So, the Turkospori brought with them the Turkish cuisine. Once again, we see the same negative attitude of the locals towards the refugees. I turn again to the world of flavors, because I would like to emphasize a point on which I do not think due consideration has been given, that the refugees' cultural contribution to Greece's gastronomic culture has at the same time played in the most simple way a highly diplomatic role in bringing our countries together. What do I mean? I believe that the refugees could be pots, sofra, tava, overflowing with melzano salata, patlijan salatas, tzatzikia, pasturma, sujukia, terbieli, yuvarlakia, aromatic keftedes, papas yachnisi, kadaif baklava, etc., were the greatest diplomat and the most experienced balancer in handling issues to bring the two countries, Greece and Turkey, together. Rarely, as we have all seen on various occasions, do the Greeks and the Turks find themselves at the same table without letting the sujukakia, yoksa, tzatziki, dolmadakia, lend them like old friends down the paths of old times. The many common names of dishes and food, even if they sometimes run up against some of our national sensitivities, are without doubt a valuable guide for both of us and you to comprehend our people's daily lives. And in the words of Anthikara, who translated the book Aini Sofrada Iki Ulke, Turk Yunan Mutfal, by Mirsini Lambraki and Engin Akin, I quote, "Maybe this is a very good way to focus to our common past, as attractively let out before our eyes, the products of our common geography in the various tasty combinations bequeathed to us with fruitful unifications of the struggle for survival with the creativity of so many unseen heroes and, above all, heroines of history. All this is the cultural achievement of the ranked Hungary refugees who arrived amidst the whirlwind of war in a foreign land, bearing their flavors, which were conveyed to the locals. This is a huge cultural contribution, but at the same time, an enormous contribution to the convergence of the two countries. I will speak about the role played by refugees in introducing to Greece urban Ottoman music and entertainment, which had various forms, from amane to the so-called rebetiko, from Karsilamades to Tsiftiteli to Zeybekika, etc. Rebetiko is a very complex topic with many unexplored aspects. But yet researchers agree that the early roots of rebetiko lie in the Smyrnian and Constantinopolitan musical tradition. Let's start from that. In a large urban centers of the Ottoman Empire, the prevailing living conditions, the corresponding social behavior, and the development of the multicultural urban culture nurtured an urban folk music, which was introduced into Greece by Anatolian refugees. It is they who were to reshape and carry on what was known as Anatolian music, namely the Smyrnaica, Amanedes, rebetiko songs played in Cafe Aman, which prospered during the final decades of the 19th century in Greece. Songs looked down on as barbaric, uncivilized, which were described as vulgar, marginal, a threat to Greek manners and customs. There are many articles containing a strong element of prejudice against urban lower classes, written by representatives of the Western raised urban culture. The same treatment was also suffered by the Shadow Theater, our old friend Caragiosa. The Asia Minor catastrophe was a milestone in the evolution of rebetiko song, which even in the early 20th century was considered the product of marginalized groups in Greek society. During the years following 1922 and up until the Second World War, it was the refugees who, either as musicians, instrumentalists, and singers, or as packed audiences, and therefore buyers of the records released, ultimately shaped folk music in Greek cities. The years 1922-1934 can be characterized as the years of Anatolian cultural domination. Performers from Asia Minor were dominated the recording industry. Great composers appeared. Panagiotis Tundas, Kostas Skarvelis, Evangelos Papazoglou contributed new material in the Anatolian vein to supplement the recording of traditional Anatolian pieces. All the lyrics were sometimes varied to reflect the social conditions in the refugee neighborhoods in Athens, Piraeus, and other cities of Greece. Refugee singers with distinctive voices left their mark forever on the first performance of these songs. I will mention a few, starting from the women. The first was Rita Badzi, the other Papazoglou, yes. And the third one, Rosa Eskenazi. There are also the men, Anestis Delia, Stavros Paiungis from Aibal, etc. The majority of them came from Smyrna and Constantinople. The refugees were also who, on settling in mainland Greece, contributed to the increasing popularity of the Anatolian music culture. Mainly through the refugees, mainly the refugees helped to socialize rebetiko songs. They attracted and increased audience who were no longer the city dropouts, but instead hardworking people from working class neighborhoods. the medical music emerged from the opium dens and entered in the popular coffee shops, tavernas, in the refugees and working class neighborhoods of Athens and Piraeus. In Prosphidica, in these neighborhoods, parties were held in every opportunity with songs and music that showed the locals their culture and philosophy on life, and which were graphically described by newspaper columnists of the time. These people sang and were moved by songs that spoke of their hard life, expressing their belonging for the life they left behind in the land of Anatolia, and these songs were the means by which they could reveal and also hold on their own particular identity. They describe in these songs the conditions of their hard life. Angela Papazoglou, this one, wife of the rebetiko singer Evangelos Papazoglou, observes in her book Ta Chairia Mas Edo, that means in, if I can translate it, there was not decent life in Greece. With the common sense of the working class people, the class inequalities, the discrimination, the social exclusion of Greek society at the time. It is obvious that the sweet, pleasant, and sensitive sound of the instruments in Anatolian orchestra with its santur, violins, could no longer express the new problems experienced by major social strata in the 1930s concerning the harsh living conditions and social confrontations. Their self-censored songs do not touch on social or other thorny issues. They are not without references to refugees. For example, I don't know if you know some very popular songs, as for example, a song in which a refugee girl silenced her lover with the words, "Why are you asking me for my origin? You don't love me," in the very popular song "Τις εμέλειες ένανε από πού είμαι εγώ, από το καρατά σιφός μου ή από το κορδελιό. What do you care when I am from? From Caratas, my dear, or from Cordelio." There are also songs that speak in the harsh criminal behavior of the locals towards the refugees, and also there are Turkish songs. The revival of Ottoman Greek cafe music in Greece started after the mid-1970s, and some remakes of old songs became major hits. I have to finish it. Dear ladies and gentlemen, I have indicatively mentioned two major cultural contributions made by the Anatolian refugees, cooking and music. two mainstays in our life. I hope someday we shall have the chance to take another look, more detailed, at these important issues that concern our common cultural heritage. Thank you very much, and excuse me.